Counting is still underway this weekend, and local and parliamentary elections held Thursday in the three countries that make up Great Britain: England, Scotland, and Wales. For more on how nationalist parties that want to break away from the United Kingdom are doing and what's ahead, I spoke with NPR London correspondent Frank Langfitt earlier today. So, Frank, why are people paying so much more attention to this round of elections?
The Scottish National Party was saying if they could get a majority or a pro-independence majority in the parliament this year, they would push for an independence referendum to be basically to break away from the United Kingdom. So people are watching this naturally very closely.
Since the last time Scotland wanted to break off, we've had a Brexit and a pandemic. How has that changed things?
Brexit was fundamental, Hari. I think that the independence referendum failed. It was only 45% voted back in 2014. And a lot of those people, quite a few of them, voted to stay in the United Kingdom because they were told it was the only way they could stay inside the European Union. 2 years later, they felt betrayed when Brexit happened. And that really angered a lot of Scots that I've talked to. And so they've been very determined not only to leave the United Kingdom, but hopefully in the future rejoin the European Union.
There's two parts to this. The leaving of the United Kingdom, that wouldn't be very simple. And then the other part is the joining of the EU. How long would all this take?
Nicola Sturgeon, she is the First Minister of Scotland. She's the head of the Scottish National Party. She looks to be hoping for a referendum, assuming that Boris Johnson will agree to this, and he said so far that he won't, maybe in 2023. But then after that, you have the question of a border between England and Scotland that runs about 100 miles. There'd be questions of a currency, things along those lines. And then in terms of getting back into the EU, it could take easily a number of years.
So in the meantime, you have a disunited kingdom.
It's definitely a risky venture. People I talk to say that it can be done, even economists, but it could be very challenging economically. And it's a very uncertain landscape, certainly in the UK, between the pandemic, recession, and Brexit.
And is there an idea of what the sentiment is? Has there been more excitement about getting to the polls? If only 45% went to the polls for the referendum last time, are they more interested and engaged in the process today?
The polls have shown roughly on the independence issue about 50-50. Back in October of last year, it got as high as 58%, a record for independence. I think the strategy of the Scottish National Party will be to get through these very difficult times and then finding just the right time to call it when they think that the support will be high and they'll be able to win it. As we know, in politics, timing is everything.
How does this change the balance of, well, I guess, Western democracies and what this does to the United Kingdom?
I think this is another reason why Americans should actually be paying attention to a story like this that they might not necessarily focus on. The United Kingdom is a close ally of the United States, both militarily and diplomatically. And so the idea that the UK could be tied up for another few years, that's for sure bad news for the United States, especially as it's facing off against a very aggressive and much more assertive China, and also Russia and Vladimir Putin. As one, I was talking to one Conservative Party politician in Scotland just a few days ago who said, you know, the idea of Scottish independence would really make Vladimir Putin smile. It's the kind of thing he wants, a fractured West.
What about the third leg of this tripod, Wales? What's happening there?
The last time I looked at polls, it was up around 35% in favor of independence. There is frustration there. Also, the big thing that I think frustrates people is that all the power is in the Conservative Party, which is dominant, Boris Johnson's party, in London, in the British Parliament. And they are very different politically than England. There's also a lot of discontent or some discontent in Wales. But Wales wouldn't be the first place to make a move. They'll be watching Scotland very closely over the next couple of years.
NPR's Frank Langfitt. Thanks so much.
Great to talk, Hari.